Most Q-types in QuickShow are generators. This means they generate shapes, text, drawings, etc., and the generation is done every frame of calculation. While this has worked well in the past, as your cues become more and more complex, the calculation time for each frame will drastically increase, especially when you have a large number of lasers in your setup. Parametric image Q-types are different. Instead of generating your content, it uses basic shapes and Q-types that are sourced from and rendered as frames. This is done before effects and generally reduces calculation time. If you're having concerns about performance or your show has many lasers in it, you should use parametric images over QuickShape wherever possible. To create a parametric image, right-click on an empty cell and click New Parametric Image. Like all different content types, on the top left you can create a new, open and save for this image, publish to the cloud, change its properties, view options, capture and pause. On the top right you have your Show It Now and Zone Selection. On the left here, you have your preview for your shape. And on the right, you have your shape settings under the Settings tab and all effects under the Effects tab. As parametric images are based on frames instead of generations, under Shape, you can select from a list of different base shapes, and below that will be all the parameters related to that shape. As you can see, there are many shape types for different uses, and the best way to know them is to explore. For this video, we'll cover the shapes you want that will replace the use for shapes made in the simple shape editor. Beam is fairly simple, it's just a single hot point where you can control its point count, position, hue, saturation, and brightness. For lines, we have a couple options. Simplest is line AB, where you can control the line points, anchor points, position, and its overall color. If you want separate control of the anchors to the line, use number 9, the line. With this, you can control similar parameters, but you're able to control the color of the anchors and line separately. For circles, you can use Ellipse or Ellipse Multi-Loop. Ellipse is a normal circle with overall size, point, and color control, and you can also control the start and finish overlap to clean up the seam. Multi-Loop allows you to draw the circle over and over in the same frame to smooth out seams and improve how the circle loops when it's moving fast. You can control the number of turns and optimize blanking. For squares, use Rect AB. Here you can control its overall point count, its start anchor and corner anchors, its side positioning, and control its overall color. For triangles, or any other number of the side shape, use Polygon. Here you can set how many sides it has, its start angle, size, and color options, as well as how dense the anchors on the corners are. There are many other options, so feel free to take a look after this video. They will follow all the similar path and shape and its parameters. Once you have the shape you would like, you can go to the Effect tab and add any effect to the shape you would like, just like any other Q-type. As well, you can use parametric images anywhere where you can use simple shapes, as we see this being a replacement for the simple shape editor in many cases. Thank you for watching our Quick Hints video on the parametric images Q-type. If you still need help, you can contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com, and we'll help you as soon as possible.